Yes, it's a good day. Thank you for joining me today. My name is Precious and this is Kali's Design Academy, where I teach how to make shoes and bags, both male and female. And in today's class, I'll be teaching on pattern drafting, mini bag pattern drafting. So let's get right into it. This is our board and our paper that we'll use for the pattern drafting. So let me just reduce it so that it will be easy for us to use. So now, this is the kind of mini bag that we want to do. We want to make is a pattern. This is like just like a prototype of a mini bag that we want to make. These are the dimensions and everything. So now, first of all, I love using this L-shaped ruler and I recommend it for everyone. Go to your nearest accessory stores, leather accessory stores, to get this L-shape. It's very good. It helps you rule accurately and faster. So now, let's start. So the first thing you consider when making a mini bag is this kind of mini bag. You know, you start your measurement. First of all, you need to get the dimension of the kind of mini bag you want to do, the height, the width, the base, everything about the dimension, so that you know the direction you are going. So now, we want to choose our dimension. So our height should be 5 inches. Our width should be 6.5. So the next thing is our base will be 3 inches. So these are the dimensions that we are going to use. It's very, very important you get your dimension so that you know how to go about, you know, drafting out your pattern. So with this now, we are starting with the front of the bag. You start getting your dimensions from the front of the bag. The direction, look, okay, this is the process we are going to use for our direction. So the first one is the front of the bag. From the front of the bag, we'll go to the base. From the base of the bag, we'll go to the back. From the back, we'll go to the allowance. From there, we'll go to the flap. So everything is connected. The front, the base, the side, the allowance, the flap is connected. So we are not cutting anyone off, it's connected. So now we'll measure. This is our measuring tape. So we measure. We have to rule a line first, the vertical and horizontal line. You rule it first so that whatever you are doing will be accurate. So this is it. So now we're going to measure. Our width is 6.5. So we measure 6.5 here. 6.5 here. Then our height is 5 inches. 5 inches. So this is our 5 inches. This is our 5 inch. So you join your points. So the next thing you do is, you get your base. The measurement of our base is 3, 3, 3, and the width of the base is definitely will be the same width with the front of the bag. So this is it. You join your points. So the reason why this ruler is very nice is when you place your points, the vertical and the horizontal will just click together. You know, that's the advantages of using this L-shaped ruler. So now this is our front, which is 5 inches. This is 6.5 inches. So this is our base, is 3 inches. Then our length of the base is also 5.5 inch. So the next process is the back of the bag. So we are going to measure the same measurement we did for the front. It's going to be the same, 5 by 6.5. so that's how we're going to do it, 5 by 6.5. then you join your points. So this is the back of our bag, which is this side. This is the base, this is the front. So this place is also 5, and this is 6 inches. So now for us to, if you look at this bag, it's like a V shape. This place is smaller than the base. The top of the bag is smaller than the base. So how do we get this from this place to the place is smaller than this place? So first thing we'll do from here to here is 6 inches. We'll remove, it depends on how V-shaped you want it. If you want it to go inside very well, you remove, you take out more inches. If you don't want it to go inside very well, you reduce the inches. So we are using half inch here, half inch, half inch. So now when you remove half inch, you join this point to your base, the base of the back. Join this point to the base of the back. So this is how we do it. We just repeat the same process here. So now the next thing, you repeat whatever you did here, you're going to do it to the front. Whatever you did to the back, you're going to do it to the front. So we'll remove half inch here, we'll remove half inch here, we'll join it to the base, same process, we'll join it to the base, same process. So this is the front, the back, the front, the base, the back. So the next thing we are going to do is the allowance. So allowance is always, in most cases, is always smaller than the base. The height of the allowance is always smaller than the base. So our base is 3 inches. So what we are going to use, our allowance should be, we're gonna say 2.5 inch height. The same width with the bag. We remember we've removed half and half here, half inch here. So what we are going to do is we'll join this point first, then we join the 6.5 inch that we measured from the back. Join the 6.5 inch here. This one is already joined, so we remove half here. We remove half inch here and join it to this point. So this place is 2.5. This place to this place will now be, you can measure it to see, to know, will be 5.5 inch. So now it depends on how we want our flap to go down. If we want it to go very down, we increase the inches. If we want it to, you know, not go down too much, we reduce the inches. So from here to here, we are taking out, we are using our flap will be 3 inches. So you measure 3 inches from here. 3 inches from here. 3 inches from here. 3 inches from here. So we now join the points. Join the point from here. Join the point from here. Join the point from here. So now this is our, this is the flap allowance. This is 3 inch. From here to here is still 5.5 inch. So now let's cut out our pattern. So you cut it out from here like this. Cut it out. Cut it out. This is very easy to do if you just follow the process. Remember, I said you start from the front of the bag. From the front of the bag, you measure the base. From the base, you measure the back. From the back, you measure the allowance. From the allowance, you measure the flap. So now, for us to get this, the shape of this flap, we have to bend our pattern like this. Make sure it's equal. Bend it like this. So now, this is our flap. You can choose to make it any design you want. But now, I'm choosing this rounded design for the front of our flap. So just cut it like this. When you cut it like this, then you bend the lines that you drew for your points. When you bend it, you now form the bag like this. So this is it. This is it. This is the front, the base, the back, the allowance, and the flap. So this is it. So hope you got it. Hope you got it. So yeah, very easy to do. It's what you can practice at home. It's very, very easy for you to do. Hope you understand what we did and you can try it at home. Thank you for watching the video. If you like the video, please like and share. If you have any questions, if you have any comments, please don't forget to drop it on the comment box. Please share our videos. Please don't forget to subscribe. Turn on the notification bell so that whenever I drop any video on how to make shoes and bags, you will always be there, you know, to see them. Thank you. Please be safe.